that's something that you can incorporate into your music if you want. If you want to write a really catchy tune, that can be an approach. Like, okay, it's like 4-bar first ending, 4-bar second ending, then another 4-bar first ending, 4-bar second ending, then the chorus, and then transition. Repeat, you know, and do that for 3 minutes, and you've got a hit. Hey, arrangers. So for this week, we'll be doing what I'm going to call, for lack of a better term, pop song form. But we're not, that's not to say that you're going to be writing pop songs this week. You can write pop songs, and I would encourage you to try writing a pop song. But that's not really what it's about. It's more about the form of a pop song. And like all forms, like all forms, the form of pop songs has some flexibility to it. And maybe it has even more than most forms. But probably the most distinguishing characteristics of a pop song form is that it usually has a section called the verse and a section called the chorus. You know, you hear this in all kinds of songs. You'll hear it in gospel songs and country songs and all kinds of songs. But there's typically like a verse and a chorus. Now, oftentimes you'll hear like two verses and then you get to the chorus. And then maybe on a repeat, maybe there will just be one verse and a chorus. Or maybe there will be a guitar solo or something like that, and then a chorus. They might even throw in a bridge. So you might have something like verse, verse, chorus, bridge, and then jump straight to the chorus. They might start the song out with the chorus. The whole idea of the pop song, or why the pop song is so popular, is that it's real catchy. So there ends up being a good amount of repetition in the form, and usually the section that we call the chorus is really a very memorable type of section. It usually is something that the verse is building to. It might have, if there's a lyric, it'll have a lot of times a real memorable type of lyric in there. You all, I'm sure, are familiar with lots of pop songs. So I'm not going to go into too much depth on what that means in terms of the possibilities. I'm sure a lot of you have really, you know, checked that out. The main thing that I'm really thinking about is the idea that there's a verse section and a chorus section, and how we can incorporate that into our music, particularly when we're not writing in a pop song style, when we're writing a jazz tune, for instance. Sometimes what's interesting too, I find myself combining forms where I'll be thinking A, B, A, C, let's say, but maybe on my C section, I'm thinking of that as also partially the chorus of the tune, even though it's not a verse chorus song exactly. So there are ways we can allow these forms to mesh with each other, and we'll get into that even more next week when we're dealing with through composed song forms. But back to the pop song form. The main idea is that you're going to have like a verse, and then probably another verse. You need that little build up, and then a chorus. And a lot of times there will be a little section in between the two verses and the chorus. And I've heard some people call that the pre-chorus. I'm not big on that term. I sometimes call it, sometimes people call it like a bridge. It's not exactly a bridge in like the traditional sense, but it is a middle section that's getting you from one place to another. I sometimes call it like the river. So here, let me make room on here to write that. And the example that I'm going to play for you all has that kind of river section. You also can go straight to the river and then the chorus. You also can go straight from the verse to the chorus. It just, you know, depends on what you want. And sometimes in the middle of the song, there'll be an actual bridge that's like a contrasting section. But you don't have to have that. The main idea is getting the idea of how all these sections kind of, and you want to be internalizing how these sections combine to tell a story. How we have a build up to the chorus from the verse, and how, you know, we get the verse twice, how there's some repetition, how maybe the second verse might end in a way that's a little bit different than the first verse, so that so that it leads into the chorus. And the chorus is, you know, something that is memorable and sticks with you and feels important enough to happen multiple times. So, these are some of the sections that might make it into your song. I should mention that today, you know, I was talking a second ago about how with popular music, we want to make music that's catchy. And this form, you know, the verse chorus idea is a part of that. It's been interesting over the years, you know, in the interest of making something catchy and making it stick with people quickly, because now, especially with technology now, people need to hear the catchy part right away. So now a lot of times songs tend to start with a chorus, I think, more often than they used to. And a lot of times too, the songs, I'll hear pop songs now where it's, you know, there's a little less development from one section to the next, and it's a little bit more like, okay, four bars of this thing, then four bars of another thing, then four bars of another thing, then four bars, and then you're done, and then it all happens again, and then it all happens again, so that it's kind of moving quickly. You don't need a whole lot of attention span to kind of follow the shape of the song. And, you know, I make no judgment about that. And a lot of those songs I like, you know. So, but that's a good thing to be aware of. That's something that you can incorporate into your music if you want to write a really catchy tune. That can be an approach, like, okay, it's like four bar first ending, four bar second ending, then another four bar first ending, four bar second ending, then the chorus, and then transition. Repeat, you know, and do that for 3 minutes, and you've got a hit, you know. Anyway, so I don't want to make it seem like there's just one way to do song form, but in terms of your assignment, the main idea is write a verse and write a chorus. And it's definitely cool to write a pop song, but I would also encourage you to play with how do you write a jazz tune in a verse chorus form. And you can think of, you know, Joni Mitchell's done some of that. A lot of people have, actually. So, anyway, let's listen to some music. I just want to play a good example of a tune that kind of does this. And it has a verse, river, chorus. And this is a Stevie Wonder tune called Overjoy. We'll listen to that, and then I want to listen to Danilo Perez's trio arrangement of the song. So you can hear how a pop song can also work really nicely in a jazz context. So here's Overjoyed. Okay, so in terms of the structure on that, it's a little different than what's written here. It's actually like, you could kind of think of it as like two short verses and a river, and then another two short verses and a river, and then the chorus. Or you could think of two short verses and a river all as being a verse. And that's actually, on listening to that, that's how that actually sounds to me. So to me, this is like verse, verse, chorus. But the verses each seem to have kind of like two sections to them, which is like a short little short phrase, and then it repeats, and then it goes someplace else. And then we have another one of those. So it's kind of like each verse is kind of like an A-A-B. A-A-B. And I think when Danilo does it, I should check, but I'm pretty sure when Danilo Perez does it, he does it just one verse and then goes straight to the chorus. I guess we'll hear it when we get there. I want to listen to this again with that in mind. And I'll talk a little as we do it. So here we go.
Over time, I've been building my castle of love, just for two, though you never knew you were my reason. I've gone much too far for you now to say that I've got to throw my castle away. Over dreams, I have picked out a perfect come true. Though you never knew it was of you, I back some other day. And though you don't believe that they do come true. For did my dreams come true when I looked at you? And maybe too if you would believe, you too might be overjoyed, overloved.
Now I want to listen to a little bit of Danilo Perez Trio doing this. And check out, you know, he manages to bring some really cool rhythmic ideas to it. You know, some nice time signature stuff. Anyway, check this out. So he does do also, he did both verses before going into the chorus, just like Stevie does. I think there's actually something about that. It's like you need that second verse to make the first one feel definitive. And without that repetition, it seems to maybe not, it would just be kind of fleeting or random. And so that's kind of cool, just thinking about like how repetition functions. You know, but it's so cool, you know, I don't know if you caught the time signature changes, but for these A sections, they're doing it in 7, and the B sections, they're doing it in 6, and then the chorus, they're basically back in 7, you know, and then they maintain that for the solos. And it just, I love that recording. Anyway, that's Danilo Perez. You know, just a couple other things to listen to. I want to listen to a great weather report tune. And this is one that does not particularly have like a verse chorus at all. But well, we won't listen to it, but I'll just mention it as far as just an example of like how you can have a chorus in a jazz song and the energy it brings. And the tune I'm thinking of is Birdland. And it gets to that section of that spot, you know, it has that energy, even though it's, I guess, fusion, but I think it's really nice to think of how a chorus can bring a certain catchiness and excitement to a song, you know, so we can incorporate that into our music beyond just pop music. We can use it in jazz, we can use it in whatever style of music we're writing. So I'll have us listen to one more example of that, and this is one of my tunes, actually, where I was definitely thinking about incorporating pop song form into the tune. And it's a song I wrote called Winter Machine. I was definitely thinking verse, chorus. You know, and the verses are kind of, it's almost like an ABAC, I guess. And then you get to a chorus section after that. And I really wanted it to have that feel, that energy of like the pop song chorus. I remember thinking that at the time that I wrote it. And then, you know, it goes some other places for solos and stuff. We might not listen to all of that, but I want to listen to the main song form. So this is Winter Machine. Oh, and again, I'll just mention that if you are interested in checking out any of the charts for especially any of my compositions, I'm happy to share them with you. So just let me know. I'll send you a PDF. Anyway, here's Winter Machine. Sorry. anyway, so that is an example of how you can bring some of that pop song form into your music that is jazz. So for this week, write some lead sheets. Again, with, you know, just write some lead sheets. Think about maybe incorporating the pop song form. You don't have to write pop songs. It's cool to write a pop song, but the assignment is more just thinking about verse, verse, chorus as an idea. All right, if you have questions, please send me a message, and I look forward to hearing your music. Have fun.